welcome back to my colorful kitchen. I'm Chef Star, and this week we're going to be preparing a Moroccan dish with lamb meatballs and some quinoa. If you've never had quinoa, stay tuned because this is going to be a delight for your palate. Here we have all of the ingredients, and we're going to start from this side with the vegetable broth that we're going to be using to cook our quinoa in. I'm going to show you that a little bit later. We also are going to be making a sauce because I like it saucy. We have tomato sauce, we have roasted tomatoes because I like the smoky flavor, and tomato paste, and of course some more tomatoes. These here though are sun-dried for a little pungency and sweetness at the same time. And then we have some ginger. Ooh, ginger smells good. We have turmeric, because turmeric is awesome. And we're gonna put that in our dish to make it a little Moroccan. We have salt, Himalayan salt, sea salt, there's big crystals, they're beautiful. And we have some diced red onions because I love diced red onions. We're gonna use one egg this time. We're gonna use some more breadcrumbs because we need those. Not really, but we want them. And obviously we have the lamb. This is actually grass-fed lamb, the best lamb, 85% lean, 15% fat. And then we have some rosemary and some mint. Oh, minty. We're not gonna put this on until the end. And we do have some eggplant, and we know how you love eggplant. We're gonna chop this one up though. And of course we have some garlic. It is so aromatic in here. It is awesome. Let's go ahead and get this party started. Oh, and we forgot to add the coriander as well as some cumin. So we're gonna get nice and spicy here. Now we can get the party started. And we're gonna go ahead and add the ginger. And the turmeric. Just a little turmeric in here. I wanna pour it all in there because I'm actually gonna put it in my sauce. We're going to use a half of, we don't want a half, no. We want a half teaspoon of the coriander. We have a substitute producer today. She's doing really well. And for the cumin, we're also gonna do a half a teaspoon. But let's put a little bit more, just a little bit. A little bit over a half a teaspoon. And we're going to put all of these together. Can't put that there. And we're just gonna grind it. Yeah. You wanna bring it in so they can see how beautiful those colors are together? Look at that. Yeah, and we're just gonna grind it up. Oh my goodness. You guys, one day Smell-O-Vision is gonna come to our homes, and the things that we are gonna be able to do with our nose before tasting it, just beautiful. So there we go. And now we're going to start chopping the eggplant. Move this over. Always use the back of your knife, once again, because you never want to scrape your blade and make your blade dull. It is with the utmost importance. And this is organic eggplant because it's the best thing. So, yep, we're gonna go ahead and just chop this up. I like to cut it in half. Look at that. And we're just gonna cut it in some thirds. Then we're gonna chop it in the pan. Yep. We're not going to chop it in a pan. We're just going to cut it up. Chop it up in some cubes. And then we're going to put it in the pan. Actually, we did this in fourths. So let's do it in fourths with that one as well. Because it makes more sense to do it that way. And we're just going to break this down until it gets a little softness to it, but not so soft, because you want that texture to go along with those roasted tomatoes. Yep. And cut them again to make them some cubes. Smooth this mint over until we're ready for it. Just beautiful. So that's not going to be until the end. Smells so good though already. I'm telling you, so good. So, I love an eggplant though, by the way. I had never had it as a child, as an adult, when I started experimenting with food, you know, to try to get familiar with different flavors. Because I get bored. I do not like leftovers. So if I make dinner, I'm going to leave anything that's left to whoever is home, because I'm not taking it to work for lunch. I need something fresh. I've always been like that. My mom used to be like, "You will not eat," but she always fed me. So, I'm really excited about this channel, you guys. First time I did weight loss on air and got distracted, stopped taping, you know, and it's been a minute. But this time, this is like my passion. Weight loss is cool and all, but it's not as good as food. I still like losing weight. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to get this completed with these chops, because I'm everywhere. So we're just taking these rosemary off the stem so we can give it a rough chop to add it to the lamb as we start to prepare the meatballs. I think this is good. I'm telling you, I just love the way this smells. It's so awesome. I'm telling you guys, make sure that your fingers are always back. And here I am with my fingers out. I'm trying to chop off a finger or something. Chop it down to the nubs. I'm gonna act right. Just a little rough chop, that's all. I'm not trying to leave all the oil on the board, but rosemary is kind of dry anyway. So you can smell it as you chop it even more, but it's not like some of the other herbs that will release all the oils on your chopping board, which is good. That smells great. Now, if you don't have access to fresh rosemary, you can obviously use dried rosemary. The secret to getting it at its best, as far as aromatic and flavorful, is to put it in the palm of your hand and use your thumb. And that breaks up those oils that has been dried out and brings it right back to the day-to-day, put it in that bottle. So we're gonna go ahead and start putting everything in the bowl with the lamb. And we'll start with the rosemary, of course. That's awesome. You bring it in so you can see what's going on in this awesomeness over here. First onion. Yeah, that looks like a lot, but it's not. Mm-hmm.
ginger.
You know, keep it simple, found meatballs. Just a little simple ingredients goes a long way, because all of this fresh herbs and spices we got over here will obviously bring everything together. And as we say, we're gonna marry it again. You can get a close up.
So this is everything, getting this laid together. So this smells awesome. That's good. Gotta put your hands in there. Don't be afraid of the meat. Don't be afraid. It's your friend. Garlic. Oh yeah.
It's like no place like home. Garlic in the bowl.
Never crack your egg and drop it into your ingredients, whatever it is that you're making, because you don't want to have any shells in there and you have your people crunching when they're not supposed to. That's not cool. I love ginger, so if you don't use so much, but I do, so I'm using a lot. More the merrier. Oh, heaven. This is heaven.
Yep. Awesome.
So we're just going to go ahead and get these meatballs together and we'll be right back.
So we're going to add a little bit of olive oil to the pan so we can get these meatballs done and cooked.
I like to put my hand in that one and get it evenly spread around the pan.
Let's turn that on.
And we're going to wait for it to get a little hot.
The pan is hot now. So we're going to go ahead and put our meatballs in. Not so much as frying them or just cooking them with a little heat. Get them nice. It's freestyle. I'm not feeding a whole bunch of people. If I was, then I would actually have made them all the same. But today, it's a day that you may be lucky and get a big one. Woo-hoo! Now, seriously, they're pretty. I'm just gonna let them cook for a little bit. They smell good already. Make sure you get them down on all sides. These are on the side, huh? I like the tongs. They're tender. Okay, but these are so easy to work with when you're dealing with small pieces of meat. Okay, so we're going to remove the meatballs. Always let them sit and get some of that grease out of it, which is just olive oil. But you don't want them to be greasy. So we're going to go ahead and add some onion to this bowl. Well, to this pan. Wow, bowl. That's a hot bowl. So we're going to be adding some onion to the pan. Because now we're going to start to make the sauce. And yes, we did add this directly to the pan that we just made those meatballs in. Because that flavor doesn't do anything but enhance what we got going on here. This is just pure deliciousness. That's what it is. Not an onion. So we now have onion and garlic in the pan. Of course, you can never have too much garlic or too much onion. It's looking delicious. So we're just gonna let this get just a nice little brownie, not too much. We're gonna add the rest of those onions. Let's get around. Smells so good. We're gonna go ahead and start to add our eggplant so that it'll break down. And instead of doing a cube, I just let it do what it did, you know? Clearly I should have chopped this in cubes if I wanted it to be a cube, but it's okay. It's gonna break down anyway. Nice and soft. Just gives a little bit more texture to our sauce. So I'm just gonna let that get soft. And then we're gonna add our sauces to the pan. And now, just a second. So you see how that eggplant has cooked down a little bit iridescent, so not too soft. That's right. Put a little bit of salt in there, just a little bit, the Himalayan sea salt. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to start adding some salt. Paste, just for a little thicker consistency. I like that. Yeah. We have roasted peppers. I said roasted peppers. Think about roasted peppers. These are roasted tomatoes, you guys. I'm just going to mix it all around. I'll add the roasted whole tomatoes. So more towards the end of the sauce marinating and marinating together, because I don't want it to break down. I want it to, I want you to be able to bite in it and taste how flavorful it is, because those sun-dried tomatoes are absolutely delicious, I'm telling you. Look at that. Plenty of texture there. So you're just going to pour a little bit of water in there. Just a little bit. So I'm going to add some of that vegetable broth as well for flavor. Just howl on the flavor. That's what you want to do. Nothing like abundance of flavor on your palate. It's absolutely amazing, I'm telling you. So there is your vegetable broth. This is a cup of vegetable broth. Half a cup of water.
fancy. That is nice and pretty. I like it. And now we add all of those flavors that we mixed together earlier. You'll start to see it change colors a little. The color change clearly is because of the turmeric. We're gonna add a little bit more, the rest of that turmeric to it. We are over here rocking and rolling. Yes. Oh, that smells so great, you guys. So great. So we're gonna go ahead and add those sun-dried tomatoes to your taste, or handful, two handfuls in my case. Just for a little bit more flavor, I'm gonna add a little bit of brown sugar. Just a little bit. So now I'm going to transfer to this beautiful dish. Look at the dish. I love it. The sauce. Get saucy. And we're gonna place this in the oven for a few moments. One thing I failed to mention at the beginning of the video is that we're gonna need 4 additional eggs for this part. So that's a total of 5 eggs that you'll need. You could just clean the eggs. We're gonna just make them sunny side up. We're gonna add the meatballs to this. So, like I said, never crack your egg over your food. I'm just gonna add it in these little pockets that we've made. I'm gonna bake this. I'm gonna add 4. If you're having more company than that, then you can add more. I'm gonna move this dish a little bit. And just pop it in the pocket. And 1 more time. In the pocket. Now to put this in the oven for the next 10 minutes so the eggs will be sunny side up. Okay, now that we have the marinara and meatballs in the oven, we're going to go ahead and prepare the quinoa. And I got 5-minute quinoa, so it can be nice and piping while that is getting going. So we're just gonna let this boil. Okay, so we're actually gonna go ahead and add the quinoa. And we're gonna bring this to a boil. And then we'll fluff it. And this will be ready to go. Notice I didn't add really too much seasoning to the quinoa because of all the other seasoning, herbs and spices that you'll find. See how it's gonna puff up. And this is actually cooking in vegetable oil, vegetable broth that we started with at the beginning. So, up. I'm gonna go ahead and roll this up, and we're gonna cut it in a chiffonade. That's basically a rough chop, and you're just putting it on top for garnish and flavor. This is kind of small, so I'm just going to roll that. Chef and I cut. So I'm gonna let the quinoa cook for a little bit more. Well, not cook. We're just gonna let it sit now so it can puff up. Take it off the heat. So this is what it looks like when it comes out of the oven. And we just went on and added some mint. Oh, it smells delicious, you guys. One moment and you'll see the finished product. All on the plate. Can I see that first? Let me come around. So here is the finished product of your Moroccan dish with a sun and side up egg. And I'll show you. This is a sunny side up egg with Moroccan meatballs and some quinoa. Okay. So we're just gonna go ahead and break it now. Cooked a little bit longer than I would like, but that yolk is perfect. Delicious, I'm telling you. So what we're gonna do is go ahead and taste it. Look at this sun-dried tomato, just all up in there. Deliciousness. So thank you so much for tuning in today. I hope and that you guys come back again next week and the next week and the next week. Stay tuned. Next week we're doing lamb chops. I'm sorry, this food is just so good. I want to get to eating it. So don't forget to subscribe.